So earlier in this year, VMware Workstation Pro became free for personal use. And in this video, I want to show you how you can download and install it so you can use virtual machines on your computer. And I want to do this because pretty soon on this channel here, I'm going to be testing out a lot of different Linux distros, and I'm going to be using virtual machines to do that. And if you want to follow along to those guides in the future, then I want you to have a step-by-step tutorial that you can look at to get VMware set up on your computer, because getting the pro version of a VMware Workstation isn't as easy as just going and downloading it. There are a few steps that you need to follow before you can get to that download button. Now, with that being said, before you can run any sort of hypervisor on your system, whether that's VMware or VirtualBox or Hyper-V, you do need to have virtualization enabled in your BIOS and in Windows. And I've got a separate guide on my channel that I made showing you step by step how you can do that. And I'll also have that linked in the description of this video. So if you need help with getting virtualization enabled on your computer, you can go ahead and look at that guide. But to get started with the download and installation of VMware Workstation Pro, I'm going to go ahead and open my browser, and then I'm going to do a Google search for VMware Workstation Pro. And then the first result we're going to get here should be the VMware Desktop Hypervisor Solutions. So I'm going to go ahead and click on that. Now we're going to have this option to download Fusion or Workstation. I'm going to go ahead and click on that. And that's going to take us to the Broadcom website. Now, this is where we're going to have to create an account before we can get the download link. So we're going to have to go and register on the Broadcom website here. So I'm just going to click on this login tab here and then click on register. So we can go ahead and register a new user. So we're going to need to register a new user with an email address. So I'm just going to use one of my email addresses that I have here and then type the text from this image here, then click on next. It's going to want to verify your email address. So just log into the email address you just used, and then you should get an email from the Broadcom support team, like this one I just got here. And then you'll have a verification code inside of that email that you can just go ahead and copy and then paste it into this field here, then click on verify and continue. And then you're going to need to enter some personal information here to complete your registration. So I'm just going to fill out these fields real quick. So once you've filled out these fields here, you can just click on I accept the terms and then click on create account. I'm not going to save this password now, and then you'll see that you've registered successfully. So what you need to do next is you can click on I'll do it later, because you don't need to build out your profile. But now you'll be taken to this Broadcom support portal. So for now, we're going to close this window here, and then we're going to need to log in, and we'll have to enter the details that we just used to sign up, obviously. So the username is going to be the email address. Then go ahead and click on next. Next, you're going to be prompted for your password. So just go ahead and type in the password that you just used to sign up, and then click on sign in. Now you should be redirected to the same page, but you should now be signed into your account. So once you get to this page here, go ahead and click on software here on the left, and then click on VMware Cloud Foundation. Then you're going to click on My Downloads, and it's going to open a new page here. Now on this page here, you're going to find VMware Workstation Pro. You can go ahead and click on that. And then on the next page here, you're going to find a few different options. So you can either download it for Windows or Linux. Obviously, we're using Windows, so we're going to be choosing VMware Workstation Pro for personal use, because that's the one we want to use. So I'm going to go ahead and click on that, and then we have a few different releases to choose from. So I'm going to click on the latest release, which is 17.6 at the time of this recording. If there's a newer release in the future, then you'd obviously just download the latest release that you have there. Now, before you can download it, you just need to click on I agree to the terms and service. And then to download it, you're going to find this download button here on the right. And if you click on that, it's going to prompt you to do an additional verification. You'll have to click on yes and go through these steps as well. Now, once again, it's going to ask you for some personal information, and you'll have to fill out these fields that has the red asterisk here, or else you won't be able to download this file. So I'm just going to go ahead and fill out these fields. Then once you've filled out those fields, just go ahead and click on I agree and then click on submit. Once that's done, you'll be taken back to the previous page where you'll have this download button again. And if you go ahead and click on that, it should start downloading VMware Workstation Pro for personal use. So if you go ahead and look at these downloads here, you can see it is busy downloading. And then once the download is finished, you'll obviously just run this file So you can start the installation for VMware Workstation Pro. I'm just going to minimize the browser for now. And then the setup wizard will launch. Now, I already have VMware Workstation Pro installed on this computer. So this is just going to be like an upgrade on my system, but you can still follow along to the same steps. This is the same as any other setup wizard. You basically just click on next. You accept the license terms, move on to the next step. If you do get any compatibility prompts, just accept those and click on next as well. You can change the install path, obviously, and I recommend that you do add VMware Workstation Console Tools to the system path, then click on next. You can check for product updates on startup if you want, and you can join the VMware Improvement Program. I'm not going to be doing that. And then I'll just click on next. You can create shortcuts if you want. Just go ahead and click on next. And then as you can see, it's going to upgrade my VMware Workstation Pro. But for you, it might say that it's going to install it. So just go ahead and click on install, and then it should install VMware on your computer. Once it's finished, you'll be able to click on finish, and then VMware Workstation Pro is going to be installed on your computer. Now, I'm just going to find it on the list of programs here in my start menu, and then click on it to launch it. Now, it didn't prompt me to enter a license key. I'm going to put an example for you on screen now what it looks like normally when you launch it for the first time. You'll just have to say that you're going to use it for personal use if you intend on doing that, and then it'll launch on your computer and it's going to look the same as mine here. Now, you can create a new virtual machine. You can open an existing virtual machine, or you can connect to a remote server. This video isn't going to be a VMware Workstation tutorial. Like I mentioned before, I'm going to be using VMware in a lot of my upcoming videos, and I've also used it on some previous videos on this channel, and I'll link a playlist with all of those videos down in the description below. You can go ahead and watch those videos because you're going to learn a lot from those videos about how to create virtual machines and then install Windows or Linux on that virtual machine and use it on your main system. But with that being said, I hope this guide's been useful. If you want to support this channel, go ahead and check out the YouTube members section. Shout out to my existing members. Your support really helps out the channel, and I'll talk to you guys soon.